Military Ridge. The Round Tops can be seen highlighted to the south. To the west is Seminary Ridge and the Confederate lines. Please refrain from videotaping or taking flash photography. And now, enjoy the program.
It is dawn at Gettysburg, July 3rd, 1863. You are standing on the westward slopes of Cemetery Ridge, just behind the center of the Union line. Through 2 days of desperate fighting, neither army, Union or Confederate, has been able to gain a decisive advantage. General Meade and his Union army have fought a strong defensive battle against waves of Confederate attacks. But today, General Lee believes his army can deliver a crushing blow. He will risk a frontal assault against the Union center on Cemetery Ridge. An attack on the Union center is Lee's last hope for victory. At 1 o'clock, 150 Confederate cannon opened fire. Union guns thunder back. The massive bombardment continues for nearly 2 hours. See its targets. By 2:30 p.m., the Confederates begin to run short of ammunition. At General Longstreet's nod, commanders shout orders, and the Confederate infantry step out of the woods and rise up from the fields. 12,000 strong, they begin to march. A mile away, some 7,000 Union troops await their advance.
To say none grew pale and held their breath at what we saw would not be true. An overwhelming, resistless tide of an ocean of armed men sweeping upon us.
Slowly but steadily, we marched forward. At every step, some poor fellow would fall, and as his pitiful cry would come to my ear, I almost imagined it the wail of some loved one he had left at home.
The Confederates traverse 1,000 yards in parade ground order, closing ranks where Union artillery tears holes in their line.
Our men reserved their fire and allowed them to come so far as in their judgment was far enough, and then blazed upon them such a withering musketry fire as literally mowed them down.
Under this terrible crossfire, the men reeled and staggered between fallen comrades, but all knew the purpose. The mingled mass rushed toward the stone wall.
In minutes, scores of men fall on both sides. Union soldiers overwhelm the Confederate attackers.
The line springs, the crest of the solid ground, and the great roar heaves forward its maddened lungs. last and bloodiest fight of the Great Battle of Gettysburg is ended.
The Union Army has triumphed. General Lee and the Confederates have gambled and lost. Their chance for victory in Pennsylvania is gone, and they have lost thousands of soldiers and many valuable leaders. Some 6,000 are dead, wounded, or captured. What propelled the Confederates forward against such odds? What compelled the Union men to sustain the fight? The same questions could be asked of soldiers, Union and Confederate, on many battlefields of this war.
You ask me if the thought of death does not alarm me. I will say that I do not wish to die. I myself am as big a coward as any could be. And give me the bullet before the coward when all my friends and companions are going forward.
A man who does not dread to die or to be mutilated is a lunatic. A man who, dreading these things, still faces them for the sake of duty and honor, is a hero.
Across the generations, this scene has continued to abide in memory as a moment when the acts of men shaped the fate of a nation.
In great deeds, something abides. On great fields, something stays. Forms change and pass. Bodies disappear, but spirits linger to consecrate the ground for the vision place of souls. Generations that know us not are heart drawn to see where and by whom great things were suffered and done for them.
360-degree picture. Battle of Gettysburg. Pretty cool.